It's the peak of spring, and wildflowers are abundant. The sun is shining, butterflies are flying, and crickets are chirping. It hasn't rained for several weeks, and some of the spring annuals are starting to set seed. Many of our viewers may have seen these tufts of white among the grasses and other annual plants. They are dry and papery and fall apart easily. What are they? A hint comes when we look at the nearby flowers. These white tufts are the fruiting heads of blowwives, also known by their scientific name, Achyrachaena mollis. Blowwives are members of the aster family, Asteraceae, and begin flowering in March. In flower, the heads look very different than they do when they are in fruit. In this photo, we see a flower head and a fruiting head side by side. As in all members of the Asteraceae, what looks like a single flower is actually a composite head of many individual flowers. In blowwives, the heads are radiate, which means they have both ray and disc flowers. The ray flowers form an outer or peripheral ring, and the disc flowers are in the center of the head. As they age, the corollas turn amber or reddish in color. This color may signal that the flowers are no longer offering rewards, which may prevent unnecessary damage to the heads by potential visitors who in turn benefit by not wasting energy on a disappointing attempt at nectar or pollen gathering. Blowwives are endemic to the California floristic province and are spring flowering representatives of the tar plants or tarweeds, a rich assemblage of mostly California natives that have diversified extensively in California and are especially well represented by summer and fall flowering annuals. Members of this genus are part of an evolutionary lineage that includes the tar plant genera Leia and Lagophylla, which in turn are members of the tar plant or tarweed subtribe Mediaceae, with about 20 native genera in California. Examples of other genera in this tribe include Madia, Calicadenia, and Hemazonia. In blowwives, the phyllaries are in one series, and each phyllary encloses a ray ovary, as in other radiate members of the tar plant or tarweed subtribe. There are 3 to 8 ray flowers that are sometimes inconspicuous with short, often erect rays. Between the ray and disc flowers, there is a single series of palaeae, or receptacle bracts, that can be either green or translucent. Most members of the Asteraceae that have palaeae, including a few tarweeds, have one palaea at the base of each disc flower. In blowwives and most other tarweeds, the palaeae collectively form a ring that surrounds the whole set of disc flowers. The center of the head is composed of 4 to 35 disc flowers. Each disc flower has a pappus of 10 broad, shiny white scales in two series, 5 outer and 5 inner, that are spreading in fruit. This photo shows a ray flower with its enclosing phyllary, an individual palaea, and a disc flower with its scaly pappus in two series. Blowwives are a common sight throughout lower elevation, open, grassy areas of the California floristic province. It's fun to find them in all the different phases that these annual plants go through. Thanks for watching and learning more about the spring wildflowers of California.